Everybody, good evening and welcome to France. We are in Po. This is the Basketball Champions League Game Day 10 Group B clash between Paul Lacortez and Anvil Wozlawik from Poland. Lacortez just 2-7 on the season, going up against a surprising Anvil Wozlawik team that's 5-4. We'll watch this game. Also, Rasta Vekta in action against Hapoel Bank Yahav Jerusalem. And San Pablo Burgos going up against Tekzoek Van Derma BK. Telenet Giants Antwerp and Eik are in action tomorrow night in Belgium. Well, it hasn't gone right for Po this season. Po Lacortez in this Basketball Champions League. Nicolas de Jong, after that incredible performance in which he led his team to victory over Burgos, suffered a serious knee injury, was lost for the season. Here you see them at the bottom of the standings. And coming into this week again, Anvil Wozlawik. Not sure how many people would have predicted them to be in third place, although they are knotted at 5-4. As you can see, with two other teams. There's San Pablo Burgos and Rasta Vekta, each 5-4. And those standings can change dramatically after tonight if Anvil do not get a win. Well, they've come with Chris Dow, Ricky Lido, Tony Roden, who's been terrific this season, Shalima, Igor Vodovsky, Jakub Karolak, Sean Jones, Roland Freminas, Mikhail Sokolovsky, who wowed us at the FIBA Basketball World Cup in China this past summer. Outstanding, helping Poland's national team make that incredible run to the quarterfinals. And for Laurent Villa's Paul Lacortez, Captain Leo Cavalier, Akini Ebekwe, Poivillon, Gerald Ayayi, Peter Corneli, Boyden Stoyanovsky, Usman Drame, Ronald Moore, Dige Diawara, Justin Dintman, and Thibaut Dabo-Brake. Paul Lacortez, a famous team in French basketball history, I think, and this Anvil team is making plenty of headlines, not only with their dynamic play on the court, but some great results, and also one of the best fan bases, really, you would have to say, in the Basketball Champions League. They have been utterly electric, both the team and the fans behind them. We'll see how they do tonight coming out of the holiday break. Remember, we've had a couple weeks off during the holidays. And we'll see if that's messed up their Basketball Champions League mojo at all. And you can see the coach of Anvil, Igor Milicic, all fired up and ready to rock and roll tonight. So that's you'd have to think would be a good sign, because he knows you can't afford to start any game flat in the Basketball Champions League, especially when you hit the road. You got to come out, you got to try to hit the other team in the mouth, so to speak, come out strong and be ready to go from the off. And Igor Milicic looks like he's all business, as do his Anvil Wozlawik players. Simon Szewczyk, the former Poland international, showing the clenched fist. He's ready to go. And we'll see how Paul Lacortez, if they're up for the game as well, if they're up for the fight. These teams obviously met back on game day 3, Anvil winning that one 95-87. The in that game. Chris Dow had 10 points, 3 rebounds, 7 assists, and 3 steals to lead the way for Anvil. Czech Imboj had 13 points and 8 rebounds for Pola Cortez. Tony Roden also had a big game that night, 23 points for Anvil. And really, Pola Cortez's current 4-game losing streak is their longest losing streak in the competition. Of course, they're making their bow in the competition this year. They've conceded more than 90 points in 5 different games this season. So that's not a good recipe to come out and not meet the opponent playing at your best defensively. Anvil have won their last 2 games in a row. You see the referees for tonight's game. Tomas Vesavicius, Zafir Yilmaz from Turkey, and Blaz Supancic from Slovenia. On the right. Vesavicius there in the middle from Lithuania. And Yilmaz on the left. It's interesting to see if Tony Roden is in the starting lineup tonight, because if he is, well, that'll be a mild surprise, with Anvil having lost all 3 games in which he was in that starting lineup. And they've won 5 of the 6 games in which he came off the bench. Now, Roden scored more than 20 points in his last 3 games off the bench. Leads the league in points in the paint with 14.2 per game. So he likes to get the ball close to the basket. Wow, he's in the starting 5. That's a good sign for Pola Cortez. Maybe they're thinking they're going to change history tonight. Ricky Lito, Roten, Jones, Freminus, and Sokolovsky in that starting 5 for Anvil. Coach Mike Taylor of Poland's national team says of Sokolovsky that when Poland put him out there, they expect him to sock it to him. He really does play with a lot of fire. You see Igor Milicic talking to Sokolovsky. Some last-minute instructions. And for Pola Cortez, Cavalier Ebekwe, the Nigeria international, Boyden Stoyanovsky, the midseason signing, Usman Drame, and Justin Dentman.
Okay. Even in transition, if they come to the low post directly, everybody get back, takes the position baseline, and 54.
Okay. Ron Vila, the coach,
hey, remember,
of Pola Cortez.
Here during the double, you have to rotate, okay, sometimes. Okay.
Kornowski, of course, was in that famous North Macedonia team. At the time, it was called the, well, former Yugoslav Republic of Macedonia, now called North Macedonia. Anyway, he was in that team that famously upset Lithuania in the quarterfinals of the PB Eurobasket in 2011. That was in Lithuania, in Kaunas.
Pass to Ricky. Ricky dribble handoff. You move. You're moving here and then coming back for the handoff. And Ricky, go for the elbow. Then you circle coming this way. Then you come in. It's going to be easy pass. No, we're going 52 where you're playing short roll game. Guys, hey, protect the defensive rebound. Every chance, push the ball. Be back by starting. So in transition, we go with the 4-man screen. Let's go. Let's go.
We heard it. Every chance, push it. This is a team that definitely likes to get after you, like to push it up the court and score quickly, which is where you often see Roten getting many of his points. So the Pola Cortez fans coming out tonight hoping to see what can only be described as an upset. If they could get the win. Thank you. Well, good evening, folks from France. We are underway, and it's Anvil Slavic taking on Polak Ortez. And it's Anvil in the dark uniforms winning the opening tip and attacking the basket to the left and coming in and scoring with immediate effect. The team that likes to play fast, it plays at two speeds, fast and faster. Here they are again, a chance to run. They get it up ahead. And again, another layup and another basket. Quick start for Roten, who for my money should be one of the MVP contenders, just simply for the fact of his ability to put the ball in the basket. He has been sensational for Anvil. But remember that stat that I read for you before the game. The three times that he's been in the starting lineup, Anvil have lost. In the other games that he's come off the bench, they're 5 of 6. So trying to change a little bit of recent history. Now driving in and missing. And quickly, the other end, another chance. You feel like the game is open. Turnover, behind the back pass, up ahead to Dittman. Pauses and then goes up and finally gets Polak Ortez on the board. That was a turnover on Lido. Sokolovsky. Over to Lido. And a little bit short. Now quickly, Bekwe. Outside, and the basket is good. And Stojanovski showing what he can do. First three of the game, and Polak Ortez have taken the lead. Kraminas, the Latvia International, blocked by Kenny Bekwe. And Bekwe called for the foul. So Freeman goes to the line and makes the first. Makes the second as well. Puts Anvil back in front. Now some full court pressure here. A token full court pressure. Remember, you saw the intensity on the face of Roten before the game. Of Milicic, the coach. Rebound. Now quickly. Sokolovsky open, and Sesame knocks it in. He socks it to him. 9-5. Polak Ortez, 11th place in the French standings. They're doing better than they are here in the Basketball Champions League. Drame gets it down low and scores. Nice sweeping left-handed shot. Freeminas gets denied this time by Ebekwe. Just kind of stood his ground, didn't even leave his feet. And Dittman goes all the way, just kind of dances past Sokolovsky. He sucks it to Sokolovsky. Bounce pass, beautiful attempt. But the shot missed by Sean Jones. Now quickly again. Freiminis, wearing the number 23, has his pass stolen by Cavalier, the captain. And Freiminis looks like he's lost a little bit of weight. Trimmed up. Drame on a Quinnipiac Star. Good hustle. And again, another chance for Ampel, where they thrive in the open floor. Beautiful handoff by Roten. Fokolovsky failed to hit the shot, but good hustle by Sean Jones. Now Sokolovsky gets it outside, and Roten misses that distinctive left-handed set shot. Dentman shaking and baking. He gets it to go, and it's going to be a three-point play opportunity. Well, there's no doubt, Justin Dentman. And he puts his mind to it. He is tough to stop. Doesn't matter who he's going up against. And that time, he took Sokolovsky on, and Sokolovsky was left wanting. But a foul called on Sokolovsky. Dentman now 7 points already. Very quick out of the gate. Roten. And a little bit of afters there between Ricky Lido and Vojin Stojanovski. Neither of those guys are going to back down, that's for sure. Oh, so they're going to call offsetting fouls on Stojanovski and Lido. Stojanovski is just going to take a seat to calm down. Good job, I think, by Coach Vila. And Shupas is going to come in. It's actually offsetting. It was a technical fouls that were called offsetting. And meanwhile, flying in was Sean Jones. Catches it deep, puts it up from deep and hits another one. He's got 10 points. That was the Justin Dentman hour, one-footed three-pointer. Roten in the lane. Jones misses. Sokolovsky there, picks it up, and then Jones there cleaning up the mess. Ampel had no answer so far for Dentman, and now the ball passed down low, and it's Bekwe who goes to work, and he's fouled by Freiminis. Kenny Bekwe doing a great job on both ends of the floor. Freiminis has to take a seat. Doesn't make the free throw. The 17-13 is the lead for Polak-Ortez. 6.5 minutes into the contest. The spin, Roten follows it up. Ball goes out of bounds. And possession going back to Anvil. Going back to Polak-Ortez. Thank you. Ekwe showing us what he's got, the Nigeria international, the two-time Olympian. He is not holding anything back tonight. Lido steps back and hits the three to get it right back for Anvil. Now Dentman for three. He hits it. Wow. Three-point shootout here at the OK Corral, and Poe Lacortez Lido give and go, and he puts it in. Takes the feed, takes the pass from Roten. And Cornelli is checked into the game, keeps it alive. Both teams scrapping away. Sokolovsky comes down with the basketball. And Leo Cavalier is whistled for the personal. Boy, Justin Denton with 13 points already tonight. And Diawara now, DJ Diawara comes in, number 35. The player, he's a slasher, and he also likes to get out on the break. So far, Polakotez more than holding their own. Lido. Sean Jones back to Lido. It's a long three-point attempt, and he missed everything. Chupas calls the play. Pass telegraphed, and Roten has it knocked out of his hands by Chupas. Great hustle back by the youngster. Oh, quick hands. He was definitely not going to give up the layup, and did even better than fouling. Force him to inbound the ball here with 21 on the shot clock. Oh, spin move finished by Lido. Boy, he's got a lot of pizzazz in his game. And now blocking foul called on Cornelli. Well, that is something that a lot of players struggle with. Sokolovsky goes out of the game. Christoph Shalim has come into the game. And for Anvil, Bekwe goes out. And Thibaut Davalbrake comes in, one of the fan favorites here for Polakortez. He'll be guarding Sean Jones. Quick pass to Roten. And Roten did a good job getting the ball up quickly. Six points for Roten. Chupas, beautiful pass. Davalbrake right off the bench and right into the basket. Lido, step back, count it. Goodness me, he's exciting. 10 points for Ricky Lido. Chupas. Donald Moore, and that's how it finishes the first quarter. Very good for the fans. A lot of scoring. This game being played at the pace you would think that Anvil Vozlavik would prefer. 25 apiece at the end of one. Polak Ortiz, 6 of 14 inside the arc. They've hit 4 of their 6 three-pointers. 3 of 6 from deep for Vozlavik, and 7 of 13 inside the arc. And both teams have only attempted 2 free throws. And what's interesting, and this is where you have to think to the advantage of Anvil, Vozlavik, is they have scored 8 points off of the Polak Ortiz turnovers. All four turnovers by Polak Ortiz have led to points for Anvil Vozlavik. Meanwhile, Polak Ortiz have just 2 points off of the 3 turnovers by Anvil. So if that trend continues. But on the other hand, you've got 7 fast break points for Polak Ortiz and just 2 for Anvil Vozlavik. You think off the turnovers that would be a little bit different, perhaps. So this is a Group B game. Also, Rasta Vekta and Hapoel Yahav Bank Jerusalem. They're in action, and Vekta losing at home 45-29. And Burgos, meanwhile, are leading Bandirma in the north of Spain 26-20 at the end of the first quarter. Second quarter action underway, and Davao Braque gets it down low, but the ball is turning over. It's called traveling on Davao Braque. There's Dow. Roten, bounce pass, and going up. And getting the foul, Sean Jones gets the body, so he will now go to the line. Oh, he got possibly fouled in a couple of different spots there. Jones only makes 1 of 2, but Anvil Vozlavik are back in front. And that's a full court pressure trap. They pass it over. Cornelli over to Dintman. Into the corner it goes. Cavalier missed everything. And basketball belongs to Anvil Vozlavik. Driving in once again and getting fouled. Free throws coming. Cornelius says, I'm the big guy. Should be able to protect it. Roten takes him on. Got him with the body. I mean, the other thing is Cornelius, if he goes straight up with his arms straight up, then he's got maybe a better argument, but it looked like he might have lowered his arms. But I'm guessing that did not work to his advantage. Davao Braque, meanwhile, goes out. Justin Dintman back into the contest. Usman Drami also back in. And Corner Lee takes a seat as well. Tony Roten, well short on the free throw. Well, certainly an interesting player. Played at the University of Washington, Roten, 26 years of age. Ball batted, but caught by Cavalier, but he's short with the attempt. Now Dow looks up the floor, 4-on-3, long shot. Dow goes up for the rebound, gets it back, hands it off, and it's Roten once again. And you're getting a feel for why he does so well in terms of getting the ball so many points in the paint, because that's where he is. Quick jumper. Deceptively long arms, Roten. Look at him. Here he goes. You're not going to stop that.
Hey, in defense, okay? Play more aggressive, okay? So when they bring the ball here, no baseline. Communicate, Leo, on the drag, okay? And when they attack here or here, okay, with the help, provoke the charge. Don't step back. You make layup. And everybody fight for the rebound. Hey, don't forget, with you and Lou, okay, 54, okay? So 54, without jump. Okay, close without jump. And rebound. Let's go.
Let's go. 1, 2, 3.
Get it.
See the sense of urgency on Laurent Vila's face. A bit of frustration. Well, Tony Roten, you know, one of these players that big name. Coming out of high school in America, big name in college at Washington. All conference as a freshman, freshman of the year. Declares for the NBA draft, first round draft pick by Memphis. There goes MBDL, the dunk. Drame flushes it. But things just never really took off for him. And he decided to come to Europe in 2018 to play in Estonia first with Kalev Cremo, and then this season Anvil. Good job defensively by Drame after making the play on offense. He denied Lido. Now Dittman to Leo Cavalier, and Dow commits the foul. Cavalier makes his first attempt. That was a risky play, but Sean Jones is able to get it in bounds safely. Here's Lido, who's got some NBA experience himself. Misses. And good strong drive, though. Denied. Dow now open floor, 3-on-3, 4-on-3 rather. Sokolovsky back in. Dow with the rebound. And there for the putback was Sean Jones. Three-point attempt And Dittman shows his humor. He misses that one. Now Dow pushes it. Coach's orders. Sokolovsky open. Count it. 5-point lead. Mihal socks it to him again. Here he is. More than anything, he just looks like he plays with so much confidence. Sokolovsky. Dittman for three. And Drame gets the long rebound. Now Moore. And great job defensively by Sokolovsky. Reaches in, hits it, goes off of Moore. Turnover up to Cavalier and lays it up and in. That's a bad turnover for Anvil. And for Pola Cortez, well, you need more of that, really. Some easy buckets. Lido spinning. Now Dittman again, he can tie it with a three. Will he look for it? Goes behind his back. Beautiful play. Wow. Cavalier. This time Moore. And good job, Drame. He's been terrific since coming into the game. And then Dittman almost with a 4-point play opportunity, but instead he'll get three free throws. He knows how close he came. Well, when you shoot it as well as he does from 3-point range, you're going to get players flying at you and framing us. Picks up the foul. Now Milicic is letting him have it, that's for sure.
We are ignorant. We are doing all the stupid things what we can do. Not boxing out. We have the non-shooter shooting, and we are not boxing out. We are letting him penetrate the only left. He doesn't have right hand. Now touching the guy on the shot. Be smart. The win is going to be ours if you're going to be intelligent. Intelligent.
Tony, go for Ricky. We ain't man up. How many fouls you have? Two. The first play, motion one. But Simon. Motion one, when he slipped, when you set a flash screen here for Chris, flash, that's gonna be left. Motion one.
Well, the biggest issue Coach Milicic had with his team was they weren't playing smart. And we'll see if they can get the shooters the ball and let them shoot and they don't make bad fouls. They force opponents to go to their undesired hand. And here is Dittman making the first. Remember, he was fouled by Framinus behind the arc, so he gets three free throws and has a chance to tie it. He's had an unbelievably good first half, Dittman. Second one is good. 15 points already on the night. And the third one is good as well. So 16 points for Justin Dittman, and we've got a tie game. Roten, oh, what a play. Oh, but he missed the shot. Uara hands it off to Dittman, who thought about launching it. Now the pass over the defense to Drame. Well, you can't say enough good things about Drame. Usman Drame has been terrific. Five rebounds to go with the 6 points. Good reverse layup, Sokolovsky. Diawara passes it back. Wide open Moore. Count it. The three-pointer. Better execution now for Pola Cortez. Framinus. And his pass goes over the head of Sokolovsky. Sokolovsky needs to grow about another 6 inches. Moore over to Dentman, shaking and baking. Into the corner. Diawara kept it alive. Chased down by Moore. Now the bounce pass to Usman Drame. Boy, how good has he been since coming off the bench? 8 points and 5 rebounds. And Drame called for the foul now on Shevchik. Drame played at Quinnipiac, the same as James Feldin of Hapoel Yahav Bank Jerusalem. Bounce pass to Sokolovsky. Wasn't able to control it, but he got it to Dow. And then the reach and the foul has been called on Ronald Moore. Takes his time, makes the first. You know, the coach just said, listen, if we play smart, if we play intelligently, we're going to win the game. That's what this comes down to. But when you're a Pola Cortez team, and they've got some good players, make no mistake about it. Dentman. Bekwe, when he has it going, he's tough. Drame's been terrific tonight. You see, that's a tough shot. That's definitely what Anvil would like to see. Now Lido. 3-point attempt. Oh, it's going to go back over to Pola Cortez. Ronald Moore brings it up. Justin Dentman pops outside. Dentman takes on Dow. Dow held his ground, and also Framinus came over and did a good job helping out. Look at Roten. And then there, much better from Framinus following up the miss. And Vila burns the timeout.
Switcher, you remember?
Let's go, let's go. We should win. Let's go.
Folks, get your Champions League basketball Champions League rather app loaded into your smartphones. Got everything you need. Follow this great competition, which is in its fourth season. You can also go to championsleague.basketball. I would encourage you to enjoy that website, enjoy that app. Listen to the Coast to Coast podcast, especially the one that's up there now. It's electric. Done by David Hine and Austin Green. There's the Beckways at 1-3 tonight, but not that time. Drame almost there to tap it back in. It's really been tough. Drame. Dow flies in. Oh, had the layup. Went to the right hand from the left side of the basket and missed it. And tough drive and finish by Ebekwe. Tom Jones doesn't like the call. Well, you're not going to, you can't complain when you swipe down on the ball like that. That is an easy call for the referee. Great strength by Ebekwe. Missed the shot, however. Free throw. Lido from deep. Again, short. And Ebekwe again, perhaps falling in love with that three-point shot. He was open. Excuse me, that was Diawara. Five on the shot clock. Dow, much better. He definitely wants to go to the right hand. Back to a one-point game. Not much time separating the game clock and the shot clock. So really, Polak-Ortiz can hold it for one, and they've got just the player to do it. Dedmon. He launches it. And then Drame fittingly gets the rebound and scores with the putback. Unbelievable. I can't speak highly enough of Drame in this first half. He has been utterly brilliant off the bench. Look at this. Not forcing anything. Look at him. He knew there wasn't much time left. He puts it up softly, gets it to fall, and goes to, folks, a very impressive 10 points and 7 rebounds in 15 minutes.
You are here. Sako, Ricky. In a moment, when Tony gets the ball, run this way, run this way. Row, you make a fake. Soko running this way. Ricky, he gonna set you screen here. Chris, when he gets the ball, sprint here. Get the ball and quick pass. Quick pass to Ricky. Quick pass and no dribble shot. Okay, you will have. If you see there is no pass, one dribble and pull up.
How good has Usman Drame been? Well, he's the highest rated player efficiency-wise for Polak-Ortiz tonight. In fact, in the game at plus 15. So I don't use that word lightly. He has been tough. Just a little bit of time. 1.7 seconds remaining. And they could have advanced the ball, but they choose not to. Interesting. Oh, and the ball hit off the back of the rim and missed. And the way that Milicic is looking, I'm not sure that was entirely what he was looking for. But great fight by both teams, especially Polak-Ortiz, who lead it 44-41 over Anvil at halftime. So Poe with one more three. Both teams with 12 makes inside the arc. And of course, Poe five made free throws. Poe La Cortez, 25 rebounds overall, including nine on the offensive glass. And Denton with the 16 points leads the way, but it's Drame's overall contributions that are making the biggest difference of all. As I stated, he's got the 10 points and the 7 rebounds. So we're at halftime. A 3-point lead for Poe La Cortez over Anvil Vlasovic. We'll be right back before the start of the third quarter. Thank you.
ejection by Johnson. As Martin goes the other way, lobs it up. Stone it is with the dunk. Off the curl. Oh, lovely pass. Stone throws it down. Tyler Stone with the finish.
Some better looks ahead. 5 3-pointers now in the game as Cousins pulls up from the mid-range. Doesn't get Tashaun Thomas goes in and cleans up with the throwdown. Shabadini, watch out!
Just to underline the point. But that lady Shabadini's hooked for a while.
Misses the first, and they need to foul. They get it back for the three. Oh, it's good! The three is good! Marco Filippone! That's why he was in the game! Jordan Paul to make the two. Filippone has made the three.
Shots up by McFadden, short. And there's bodies flying everywhere. Ricky Lino ahead. Sokolowski behind the back for the throwdown. Still right. No good. Falls loose. They get it back. Still. And Gunners will win it. That's extraordinary. That is incredible.
pass, hand off. Tag the screen strong. Tag strong. You set the back screen. Contact back screen. You roll, pop. Soko gonna be in the corner. Right? Green. If it works, we go again. Guys, let's pick up defensive rebound. We're gonna win this game.
Hand off with Justin. Step up screen. Play wide. The short roll here. Leo, you catch. Okay. Hey, let's go, guys.
Well, we're about ready to start the second half here. And Polak Ortez coming out with an inspirational first half against the red-hot Anvil Vodslavik. And wondering Longville if his team's going to be able to press home the advantage here at the start of the third quarter, or are we going to see a fast start by Anvil Vodslavik? Well, Justin Dittman, a lot depends on him. A lot depends on Usman Drame. Those two have really been solid for the home team tonight. And for Anvil Vodslavik with 41 points on the board. Well, they're right there. So second half action underway. Tony Roten shaking and baking. Bounce pass and Sean Jones denied. Good defense down in the interior. Sokolovsky gets the, it's like they're playing almost a zone. Ibekwe misses with the jumper. Layton crosses mid court. And then turns it over. Stoyanovsky, who left the game after that little tete-a-tete with Lido and didn't come back. And Juan Vila felt like his team was doing well enough without him. Now the pass to Cavalier, knocked away, but it'll stay down at this end. Here's Drame catching it, has to hand it off, does so well to Dintman, who goes in and gets it to go. Took it right at Lido. The Polak Ortez lead now 5 points. Lido. Framinus puts it up from deep right at the end of the shot clock. Cavalier rebounds the air ball. Dentman behind his back puts it up. And good job by Lido to shield Stoyanovsky from the basketball. Lido puts it up from deep. And that's good. Back to a 2-point game. He's having a good time out there tonight. 13 points, Ricky Lido. Only his third make, though, from 8 attempts. I guess that's probably, you'll accept that. Stoyanovsky out of Cavalier. Stoyanovsky, count it. And he gets it right back for Polak Ortez. Stoyanovsky brothers can certainly drill the three ball. Lido. Roten from downtown, and so can Roten. Seven points for Tony Roten. Yeah, good call. He had his arms draped all over Ibekwe. Entry passed on Drame. Unsuccessful. Ibekwe, meanwhile, open and buries it. Second three-pointer of the night. Well, he gets a lot of arc on that three-point shot, doesn't he? Framinus. Cavalier bounce pass, Stojanovski. And Milicic burns another timeout. His team now trailing by 7 points. Great bounce pass by Cavalier. Points becoming a factor, as you can see.
Hit the next screen here, attack, and then we have the new role every time. When I call 5-12, it's going to be a slip, this guy. When he attacks, you have to follow him. The point guard attacks, you have to follow him.
Called on Stojanovski, I believe. Yep. And getting down the ground, Dow loses it over to Dintman. Cavalier over to Stojanovski. Steps inside the arc and he's fouled, shooting the long jumper by Roten. Lead of the night is right now at 7 points. If he makes this, it'll go to 8, and it does. Ito. Drame comes up to help out. Sokolovsky puts it up from deep. Drame with the rebound. Now Dintman. Drame open. Boy, we haven't seen this from him tonight. But he's doing it all, folks. Usman Drame. The improvement in his game is phenomenal. Rebounds. Sokolovsky again puts it up from deep, misses. And James does a great job of getting the offensive rebound and then getting fouled. Kupas comes back into the game, has some bright moments in the first half. when he entered the game for Stojanovski. All the momentum right now with Pola Cortez. But Vila knows this team from Poland can put in the points in a hurry. They really, they have not been able to solve Drame anywhere on the court. He has been the best player on the court by far. And additionally, they've got the problem of Dittman. And Ebekwe pops up and makes big plays as well. So right now, everything going the way that Pola Cortez hoped it would, certainly at the start of the game. Dow picks up the foul. Oh, good quick hands by Lido, but Drame alertly gets it back, but not with enough time on the clock. But the hustle is out of everything. You have to applaud him for that. I mean, he is not giving up on anything. Okay, he is going to do very well as a professional player, Drame, judging on his performance tonight. I'm sure his coach wishes that he could have been with them for the entire season. Lido steps back from deep. And again, Drame boxing out. Boxing out James and winning that battle. So he had only played Drame one game against Rostovetta. He played 19 minutes and had 8 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists. He just takes a seat and exits the game with a very impressive stat line. 13 points, 10 rebounds, 2 blocks. Ebekwe misses from deep. Dow. Cornelly back into the game for Pola Cortez. Good help. And traveling. He's just trying to stay positive. Cornelly, his pass just a little bit behind Cavalier. Lido, spin move, takes it in. And boy, that is a big play. You're talking about a potential 5-point swing here if he makes this free throw, remembering the turnover at the other end. Foul was called on Ebekwe for the reach. A 3-point play. Makes it a two-possession game, 58-52. Chupas misses everything. Two bad possessions in a row now. And the handoff down low, and the dunk from Sean James. And Laurent Vila, knowing the comeback is on, calls timeout, and a very wise timeout at that. You cannot take your foot off the pedal at any stage of the game. You cannot afford to suffer lapses in execution. And really, the shot by Chupas, I think, was a little too quick at the other end.
Time.
back, okay? We have to stop the ball. Everybody comes here, okay? And we run with the pass outside from this way, from the top. Okay, rotate. Nothing easy, okay, like this. Peter and Ekene, okay? On ball screen, okay, remember, step, okay? And maybe rotate this between you, okay? Play with reason, okay? And remember, we can alternate with shoulder, okay? First pass high, okay? We run, the four-man receives the ball, and the five-man, Peter, screen, and we play the corner.
Go! Yeah, and just, and, 1, 2, 3!
Well, Moore gave up the baseline that allowed Lido. Watch this. He just lets him go right easily. And then the rotation from Ibekwe leaves his man open and allows Sean James just to step right in for the two-handed dunk. And fortunately for Pola Cortez, Savicius has ordered the ball back to them. Now shaking his head as if to say he hadn't touched anything. Dintman, Cornelli, boy, that was big. Three-pointer, huge. I mean, that's a huge shot with the comeback coming from the visitors. Lido, again, takes the contact and goes to the line, showing his quality here on the last couple of trips down the floor. Fouls on Cornelli. Lido does a good job making the shot and cutting it back to a 4-point deficit. Now, Anvil have to play defense. Yeah, that was Dentman range. He was thinking about it. Ibekwe. Oh, Roten. Roten flies in. Oh, Lido is trying to score with the putback. Oh, and an unsportsmanlike foul has been called on Sulima. For the hold. Have a look at it. Well, they will go and look at it again. They'll review it. Well, no, they're not going to review it. And Dentman, incredibly, as good a shooter as he is, misses the free throw. Misses the first free throw. Well, they must have grabbed him. I couldn't see it on the replay. They must have been confident it was the unsportsmanlike. What a great game tonight, man. Pola Cortez and Anvil Vodslavik here in France. Dentman over to Moore. And the foul gives it right back to Anvil. Lido shaking and baking. Now Dentman. Going for the steal and the foul called. Lido and Dentman each with 19 points to lead all scorers. crowd wanted an unsportsmanlike foul. Denman calmly sinks the first. Wow, he's only two of his last four at the free throw line. And it's a 6-point game. The little things do add up. Roten. Good challenge by Chupas. Now Dentman. The ball turned over. Good play by Dow. Takes the contact, goes in and scores. Did a good job of getting himself in front of the defense. And then extending his right arm to score with ease. 3-second differential in the game clock and the shot clock. Dentman passes it back outside to Beckwe again. Misses. They've got time. They've got to hurry. Roten. Oh, he could have had a better shot than that. And believe it or not, a foul might have been called here as Dow grabbed the offensive rebound and was going for the putback. Watch this again. No, they have not called it. Okay, they want to see if there's still time on the clock when the foul was committed, and that's what they're going to do. Because if they determine there was time, and I think there was, I think we're going to have Dow getting a couple of free throws. Watch this. Yeah. Yeah, before the letting on the basket. But Roten had, I think he had more time. Yeah, he still had about 3 seconds. So he's going to say two free throws. Well, they've been able to go and look at the video, which is the right thing to do. They've taken their time, and sure enough, the foul called on Cornelie, who just hasn't really been his night tonight. And Dow, that last little effort there on the offensive rebound, will go to the line. Yeah, that's right. So it's half a second left. Dow takes the free throw and makes the first one. And the second. So that was potentially a very important play. They get it off in time. Wouldn't that have been something? If he'd hit a three, it would have ended up helping Poe LaCortez, but in the end, it was Anvil Voslavic that benefited. So, Poe LaCortez nevertheless lead it 63-61 over Anvil Voslavic at the end of three quarters. Poe LaCortez 9 of 26 inside the arc, just 6 of 22 for Voslavic. And Voslavic doing a better job at the free throw line and as well as inside the arc. And you can't help but think that maybe Poe LaCortez have left the court at the end of the third quarter. They should be up by more than 2 points, definitely. It feels like it should be more like a 5 or 6 point lead. And yet, Abel Voslavic, after a very difficult third quarter, have somehow managed to cut that deficit to just 2 points. And in fact, ended up outscoring Poe LaCortez 20-19 in the third quarter.
So what does this game mean tonight? Well, remember, Anvil come into this game in third place and hoping that they will get a win to remain at least in third place at 5-4. So if they win, they go to 6-4. If they lose, they drop to 5-5, and they would be in danger of San Pablo Burgos leapfrogging them. Rustavecht have already lost tonight, so they're not gonna leave them. And meanwhile, Burgos are leading by 3 points over Bandirma late in the third quarter in Spain. Pola Cortez, meanwhile, well, they're down at the bottom of the standings at 2-7 and in desperate need of wins the rest of the way to try to get into the top four. So they need to do everything they can to get a win tonight. And as long as Usman Drame is on the court as he is there, I think they've got a great chance of holding on. Because he's in team of the week territory right now. He's playing that good. Drame now with 15 points and 10 rebounds. And now the turnover. Little flits of indiscipline kind of hurting, or erratic play hurt this Anvil Slavic team. And now they have called a technical foul, a flop on Sokolovsky. Well, he went down. Ebekwe did kind of, again, lead with his right forearm. But Sokolovsky doesn't complain, to his credit. But it didn't look quite as straightforward to me. But nevertheless, just from that angle, there might have been a clearer angle to show that he did. And Ebekwe misses the first. Or rather, misses the technical free throw that was given for the flop. Chupas from three. And the ball hit out to Sokolovsky, who finds Dow. Oh, through the legs, over to Lido. Oh, that would have been on the highlight reel if he'd made that. Then the reach. And Chupas called for the foul. Look at Dow, through the legs. All Lido has to do is make this, and they're on the top 10 plays of the week. Kowinowski, meanwhile, checks back into the game. And James misses the first. Excuse me, Jones misses the first. And misses the second as well. Oh, beautiful bounce pass from guess who? Drame, finished by Moore. Foul called on Pola Cortez. Usman Drame, 15 points, 10 rebounds, 2 assists, 2 blocks. He's plus 24 efficiency. Stojanovski, meanwhile, called for his fourth foul of the game. Corner and swatted by Drame.
Three blocks now for Drame. Meanwhile, it doesn't matter if Ricky Lido comes out and drills another three and cuts it back to a three-point deficit. Cortez have to keep the scoreboard ticking over. Good job coming off the bench. Christoph Salima. Way. Fights his way inside. Look who gets the rebound. Drame. It's an extra possession and Moore misses, but Drame another rebound. 12 rebounds for the night. To go this 15 points and three blocks. And Moore now misses. And incredibly, Drame didn't get the rebound. Good effort by Dow to keep it alive. Kovacic missing the three. Three-pointer is good from Moore. It's his second make from eight attempts, but nevertheless, it was a big one. Goes it Moore, and then he passed. I don't know if he thought Shevchik was going to cut back to his right. He turns it over. Framing us back into the game. Uwarev, nope, and Drame gets the rebound, winning his team possession after possession after possession. Usman Drame now with 14 rebounds. Look at this. How does he get that ball? That is just effort. Beautiful pass. Tell you what, his numbers could be a lot better, Drame, if some of his teammates were finishing shots as well. Lido. And Roten missing from the right corner. Just a block. Yeah, they've called a flop on Chris Dow. the technical free throw, and it is made. I think Milicic is asking, what is my guy supposed to do? So the guy runs into him. Referee has to call what he sees, that's for sure. Iwara hits a big jump shot. So it turns out to be a three-point trip down the floor and a nine-point lead, forcing Milicic to call timeout. Crunch time. Let's listen to Coach Milicic.
Easy left. Ricky. Open up, Soko. Get the ball. Ricky. Chris. Tony. Chris, go down. And in the moment of pass, set him a screen here, roll, for Soko. And you have to block him down. It's going to be wide open left. If no, set a screen for Chris. Take that 1 3-point shot. Okay, if there's nobody, then you're gonna play. There's no layup here.
Well, Igor Milicic knows his team's chances of getting an important road win are starting to fade with this run. Polak Cortez. They need to get it going. They need to get it going now with less than 5 minutes remaining. Down nine. Kramenis puts it up. Rebound. Sokolovsky. Dow gets it. Roten. Short. And Drame rebounds it. He's now got 15 rebounds to go with his 15 points. Stoyanovsky. And Ebekwe goes up, has it blocked from behind. Crowd wanted a foul, but Lido. Tough move, boy. Huge sequence. I tell you what, that would have been a nail in the coffin if Ebekwe had gone up for a dunk here. But he had the ball blocked from behind by Lido, who then goes down and yet again has a chance for a three-point play. Ron Jones comes into the game. Kramenis goes back out. Lido with 24 points. Make it 25. Six points the difference now. Good hands, almost forcing the turnover. Entry pass. Diawara, oh boy, has he hit a couple of big jump shots here in the fourth quarter. He hasn't produced much, but what he's produced has come at the right time, that's for sure. Diawara, and then keeping it alive, Sokolovsky. And leading to getting the ball to Jones, and Drame called for the foul. Oh yeah, it looks like good defensive effort there by Drame. But these things even out over the course of the game. And Jones makes the first. And the second.
They're back to a 6-point deficit, but they need stops. And they got to box out Drame, who continues to be a headache on the boards. Diawara, meanwhile, turns it over, and it leads to a fast break. Roten goes up and misses the layup. Boy, that was going to be a tough finish. Probably should have done better. That was definitely a big miss. Now Drame, and Stojanovski sneaks in there and takes the offensive rebound. Bounce pass. And Jones picks up the foul. Here's a Beckwe. Definitely made an impact on this game. Off target at the free throw line, which is not good when you're trying to put a team away. Probably the biggest issue the Polak Ortez have had tonight is their free throw shooting. Now they are 10 of 18, which is 55.56%. If they hit the free throws, this game would be, for all intents and purposes, over. But now Stojanovski comes up with a steal, and Lido commits the unsportsmanlike foul. So he's disqualified because it is his second unsportsmanlike foul. Gives a little look at the ref before he leaves the court. I tell you, the body language, the look coming from this Anvil Slavic team before the start of the game, they looked determined. They looked ready to come out and to get a very big road win. And all they have done is they have encountered an inspired Polak Ortez team tonight that, were it not for their poor free throw shooting, would already have basically put an exclamation mark on this win. Can happen in the last 2:25 of a game, though. Don't forget that. Polak Ortez up 8, however, and with possession. Drame, the player of the game, hands it off to Diawara, who now puts up a 3. Boy, where did his offense come from tonight? And it came in the fourth quarter. What a bonus for Polak Ortez. Great drive by Dow to get to the free throw line. Beckwe picks up the personal. Now makes the first. They've got a pulse, but that's probably about as good as you can put it. Haven't really been able to stop Polak Ortez. But really, Polak Ortez, I mean, if they're smart, they can take some time off the clock. But no, they turned it over. And then Roten took the quick 3. Dow then is fouled by a Beckwe, and that is definitely not what Polak Ortez needed, stopping the clock and putting him on the line. Yeah, he just kind of ran into him. Corner Lee comes back into the game. So five fouls on Ebekwe sends him to the bench. Don't look now, folks, but Avo Vlaslavic showing signs of potentially pulling off a miracle comeback here. Dow makes both free throws, again with the clock stopped. Iwara, who's just hit three big shots, goes out of the game. They get another guard in to handle the ball. But Iwara was terrific. Stoyanovsky. Over to Moore, back to Stoyanovsky. Now to Dentman. More than happy to let the clock tick down. Dentman, back to Moore. Stoyanovsky for three. And fortunately for Anvil, the ball bounced off the rim and over the backboard. So with 1:25 to go, there's a pulse. There's a little bit more of a pulse now for Anvil. If they can get a shot here, pass back outside. Sokolovsky for three, and that was short. And that might have just done it. Dentman from deep. That's good. And that six-point swing, you have to think that has probably been the final nail in the coffin. I tell you, that's a confident player taking that shot, Dentman. He's hit some big shots, more so in the first half. 3 of 8 from deep.
I want to see he score. He score. Stay on zone press. Try to deny. When they inbound the ball, when they inbound the ball, go for a trap. And I want second line to go this way. Second line to go this way. Sean, you're going to be somewhere here to make a steal. Maybe here. Okay. They play. Sean, Tony, when they inbound the ball from here, inbound the ball. You come on slip. You penetrate. You step in. Soko. The inbound. Chris in the corner. Slip and you go strong. Sean, deep. Walk your leg like this.
Well, Dittman kind of set the tone early. And Usman Drame came in and really led this team in the crucial moments as they really stayed on top. And now Dittman has come back and hit a big three-pointer. Wow. Tough shot. Back to an 8-point deficit. Now reaching in with the steal, framing us, pump fake, Sokolovsky blocked. They don't have time, they got to put it up. Dow puts it up, misses it, but there for the follow was framing us. And all of a sudden, don't look now, folks, but once again, it's a 6-point game, 83-77. Looks like Sokolovsky had done just enough and Corner Lee came flying in to get the block. Al missed everything, so they were lucky there because Framinus had an easy catch and put back.
Hey, guys. Okay, hey, focus. Okay. We have one. So the ball is like this. Well, you are here with the ball, okay? Voidan from here, Peter. Tu vas être ici. Usman here, okay? And Justin here. So first, stagger, okay? Go like this. If you don't receive the ball, go wide, okay? To open this slot, okay? Voidan, screen for Peter. Peter to get ici. If you receive the ball, pass back, okay? If it's not possible, cut and pass to Justin to get the ball. Hey, Usman, screen with Voidan, and after you flash. So we have, hey, we have.
And again, this would be a foregone conclusion now. If Polak Ortiz had done a better job at the free throw line, but they're 11 of 20, 55%. So that's kind of left the door open for a comeback. Although it's an unlikely comeback, it's still possible because of those missed free throws. More to Cornelli. Back to Dentman. Pulls up, and he's just going to ice it. 8 points to lead. Framinus off the back of the iron. Drame with another rebound. 16 rebounds to go with his 15 points. Don't you love a stat line like that? Alley-oop, nope, Cornelli decides to get it back. And time has run out on Anvil Voslavic and their chances to get a valuable road win. Ball thrown out of bounds. Well, this result will raise some eyebrows, and you know, it's definitely kept Polak Ortiz in with a shout. If they can play as well tonight, next week, and the week after that, and the week after that, who knows? Anything is possible.
Okay, we play for the 3-point shot, okay? So, Ronaldo, you have the ball here. Nice shot, okay, special. So, Usman here, Justin here, Boydan.
Hey, I got a second three, man.
Boydan's here, and Peter here. So, first, Boydan, you go like this, okay? Peter, no, Justin, screen like this and turn around, okay? So we want Justin here and after Peter and Usman elevator screen for Voidan. So maybe, hey, go before the ball, okay? When the ref pass the ball,
so Anvil Voslavic won the first game back on game day 3, 95-87. And, you know, I guess it's not out of the realm of possibility that these teams could end up in some type of tie for, you know, third and fourth place, a couple of other teams. But if you're Polak Ortiz, leading by 8, and you definitely want to get that advantage. And that's why they were calling that. And, you know, these points are important at the end of the game, with 2.6 seconds to go. Oh, they free it up. They get it. And unfortunately, they do not finish off with the advantage. But nevertheless, they get a big win. And all credit to Coach Vila and his team tonight. They just, despite their free throw woes, wanted it a little bit more. They went 85-77 over Anvil Voslavic. Well, I can't say enough. I've been talking about him all night, and I'm just going to do it again. Usman Drame, 15 points, 17 rebounds, 3 block shots, plus 31 efficiency. He has got a great shot to make the team of the week. If I had to vote, I don't care what happens the rest of the way. He's on it for me. He was terrific and really has fueled some hope in this Polak Ortiz team, giving them hope not only in the Basketball Champions League, but in France, as you look at these end-of-game stats, they need to improve on that free throw shooting. But overall, the 17 assists, the 47 rebounds overall, and remembering 17 of those grabbed by Drame, just an inspirational effort from him. A great night for Dentman with 25 points as well. And Ebekwe had 11 points. He fouled out. Also had 7 rebounds at Beckway and 3 steals. Lido, 25 points, but he was disqualified after picking up a couple of unsportsmanlike fouls. And you always like to see the players go and thank the fans after the game. That's a nice connection there. That's a real thrill for them to come down and slap some skin with the team. Nice community spirit. The Drame, there he is. Bounce pass. Have another look at it. Bam, right there. Yeah, it's so good, let's look at it again. Lito had it working for a while. As you look at these end of game stats, with going over who these teams have coming up next, Pola Cortez will again be at home. This time they will host San Pablo Burgos, the team they beat in the first leg. Don't forget, after that incredible Nicholas Dijon night, and he was the MVP of the week. And Anvil, meanwhile, will be at home against Hapoel Bank Yahav Jerusalem. So, you know, things are not going to get any easier for them. There are tough games for both of these teams next week, and that's how it should be in the Basketball Champions League. You don't expect easy games. Anvil will, the following week, be at Telenet Giants Antwerp, and they will be at home against Bandirma, and then they'll play at Ike. So, you know, this was a very potentially, you could see this being a loss that could end up keeping them out of the playoffs, even though they still have four games remaining. So again, they'll be at home against San Pablo Burgos, then they have to travel to play in Jerusalem. And they'll be at home against Antwerp, and then they'll finish up at Bandirma. But again, if they can come, if they can show up and play in their next four games with the focus and the execution that they show tonight, if Drame comes out and is a factor, if DOR gives them a little bit extra on offense, you know you're going to get some good play from the whole cast of characters, you know. Who knows? Don't write off their chances. They're 3-7, now two games out of the top four. Anvil Poslavic dropped to 5-5. And Burgos have won, so they are now 6-4 in Group B. So that's it one last time here from France, folks. 85-77, Pola Cortez winning it over Anvil Poslavic. Game day 10. Thanks for watching.